not accept foreign debt that could compromise your sovereignty. Protect your interests, preserve your independence, and just like America, always put your country first.
我要强调的是，共建一带一路不是有人说的这样那样的所谓陷阱，而是中国同世界共享机遇、共谋发展的阳光大道。
Taking decisive action to address our trade imbalance with China, we put tariffs on $250 billion in Chinese goods, and we could more than double that number. But we hope for better.
走保护主义、单边主义的老路，不仅解决不了问题，还会加剧世界经济的不确定性。
As the president said just a few hours ago in the Oval Office, we have great respect for President Xi and great respect for China. But, in the president's words, China has taken advantage of the United States for many, many years, and those days are over.
历史告诉我们，如果走上对抗的道路，无论是冷战、热战还是贸易战，都不会有真正的赢家。
As we speak, as we're all aware, some are offering infrastructure loans to governments across the Indo-Pacific and the wider world. Yet the terms of those loans are often opaque at best. Projects they support are often unsustainable and of poor quality. And too often they come with strings attached and lead to staggering debt. Not long after our War of Independence,My nation's first president, George Washington, warned of the dangers that could undermine all that we had achieved, debt and foreign interference. And so today, let me say with great respect to all the nations across this wider region and the world, do not accept foreign debt that could compromise your sovereignty. Protect your interests, preserve your independence, and just like America, always put your country first.Know that the United States offers a better option. We don't drown our partners in sea of debt. We don't coerce or compromise your independence. The United States deals openly, fairly. We do not offer a constricting belt or a one-way road. When you partner with us, we partner with you, and we all prosper. So let me be clear. The United States of America seeks a better relationship with China based on fairness, reciprocity,and respect for sovereignty. The difficulties that the United States and other nations face with Beijing have been well documented by our administration. China knows where we stand. But as President Trump has said, in his words, we want to strengthen the relationship between our two countries and improve the lives of our citizens. And as the president prepares to meet with President Xi at the G20 summit in Argentina, we believe that progress could be made.Progress could be made between our two nations, even as the United States remains in a strong position. Now, let me be clear again. China has an honored place in our vision of a free and open Indo-Pacific. If it chooses to respect its neighbors' sovereignty, embrace free, fair, and reciprocal trade, uphold human rights and freedom. The American people want nothing more. The Chinese people in the entire Indo-Pacific.deserve nothing less.